stolen?
I did not report the wallet stolen because I was able to cancel all of the cards. The only thing that was in there was the driver's license and the cash. I assumed that I would not get the cash back. That is very uncommon in these situations. And I believed at the time that when I requested a new driver's license, it would have invalidated the old one. That is, I am not an expert on the DMV system, but that is how it has been explained to me previously. It's just been very stressful. Essentially seeing my name attached to arson is very damaging, especially right now. I'm undergoing a job shift at work. It's a bit of a promotion. And so now when I have people doing background checks on me, it's showing my LinkedIn profile and right below that, arsonist, which that's obviously very detrimental for me just personally. And then professionally, it can hold me back a lot. I was not affiliated with them in any way. I have been in Greenville, South Carolina the entire time. I was not in Columbia at all on Monday evening. Very stressed out. I mean, I'm feeling a lot better now. City of Columbia has stepped up and are starting to work on it. The main thing now is getting other press outlets to remove those stories from online. It can be very difficult because they essentially rely on the police information being accurate. So when they conflict, my name still shows up as that, even if City of Columbia is acknowledging that is not the case. It's just stressful generally. I would just like to see more vetting of people. My main concern and why I want to talk to you is, could this be happening on a different level? Are other people besides myself having their reputations tarnished online because of something they didn't commit? And absolutely worst case scenario, could there be people who have been charged under the wrong name? I'm just trying to make sure that people's reputations aren't tarnished by something they didn't do.
You know, is there any tips or advice you want to tell people that might have lost their wallet?
I would say at this point, just report it. Report it to your DMV. If it's a driver's license, report it to your DMV. Potentially with the Real ID system, you might actually need to report it to the Social Security Administration too, because those can be linked. So I would say, even if you think it's not worth the time to report it, like me, you won't get your cash back, just report it. It can save you a lot of hassle in the future.